Racing to the 2022 Breeders' Cup, and this time we get an update on the latest Breeders' Cup news and take a look at Future Stars Friday. Some of the announcements starting to come out with the fields, and the big news from Monday, Blackbeard, who would have been one of the favorites in the Juvenile Turf Sprint, he has been retired. He does have some knee chips. He won 6 of 8 lifetime starts, ran every month from April to September, but getting ready for one of his final workouts before shipping over for the Breeders' Cup, Blackbeard, they noticed something wrong with him. He is now retired, and still plenty of horses left for that field. Now, Flightline arrived Sunday afternoon at Keeneland. He shipped out early Sunday from California. He jogged on Monday. He is going to be the Breeders' Cup Classic favorite. Rich Strike is going to the Breeders' Cup Classic. That means we will have an 8-horse field. Future Stars Friday is going to have 5 races for juveniles, starting off with the Juvenile Fillies. We've got Chop Chop and Tell Me No Lies, Raging Sea, Wonder Wheel. The good news is it looks like we're going to get about 10 or 11 horses for the Juvenile Fillies, including Chocolate Gelato. She is going to be favored in this race. You look at her winning the Frisette Stakes. What I like about this race is she made that move from off the pace in the far turn, kind of a long sustained move, took the lead, and then powered away to victory in the Grade 1 Frisette. Of course, the Juvenile Fillies, the favorites most likely going to be Chocolate Gelato, Chop Chop, and Tell Me No Lies. Those three most likely to vie for favoritism. Now in the Juvenile Turf, and the winner is a recent winner, I'm Very Busy, Packs a Wallop, and Major Dude, all confirmed for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf. Looks like Web Slinger and Dubai Mile are also coming over from Europe. But one of the horses to watch will be Silver Knot. Look at this move, coming from last to first in his most recent start. Did that at Newmarket. Definitely going to be one of the favorites on the day. Of course, the Euros usually do well. Silver Knot is definitely going to be one to watch in that race, as he made a powerful move here. I like the way he rated off a little bit slower fractions, powered to the lead. Now the Juvenile Filly Turf is going to have Free Look, Pleasant Passage, Knock Your Socks Off, Last Call, Showgirl Lynn B. But the favorite in the race is most likely going to be Blue Rose Sen. And Blue Rose Sen, another last to first move. She made actually more of a front running type move as she powered her way to victory here. And Blue Rose Sen definitely going to be one of the top three favorites in this race. Good pedigree. I think just the right connections. Strong recent race. Blue Rose Sen, definitely one to watch in this race, the Juvenile Filly Turf, as she is going to be taking on Free Look, Comanche County, Country, and Alluring Angel. Probably 14 to 17 horses expected to be in that Juvenile Filly Turf. Probably 18 to 19 horses pre-entered when that comes out on Wednesday. Now, the Juvenile Turf Sprint. Even though Blackbeard retired, we're still going to get Lazoo, Persian Force, Speedboat Beach, a recent stakes winner from California, the Pride of Prairie Meadows, Tyler's Tribe, the Iowa bred, has won 5 straight races, has some fast speed figures, but one of the favorites also could be Love Reigns. Look at this debut performance. Wesley Ward sent it out as the speed of the race. Had a 3-length lead going into the turn, wins by 7, a powerful victory for Love Reigns. She definitely is going to be one of the top 3-4 betting choices, one to watch for. A nice race about this race. It was fast early and fast late for Love Reigns. And Persian Force, another one. Speedboat Beach will take some money, trained by Bob Baffert. Tyler's Tribe, blowing them away, and Iowa continues to work well. I think 17 to 20 horses are going to pre-enter this race. A full field expected for the Juvenile Turf Sprint, as the turf races will all probably have overfield entries on Wednesday. Now, some of these horses may cross enter, but these are the most likely races that they are going to run in on that Future Stars Friday. Don't forget, the Juvenile also goes. You've got 3 Grade 1 winners in the race, and basically, You've got the winner of the three big preps. You got the Keeneland Futurity, the Del Mar Futurity, and American Feral, and the Champagne Stakes. Forte, of course, had to slug it out down the stretch. He had a good duel with Loggins. Loggins is going to pass on this race. He's going to start going down to the fairgrounds this winter, get 40 days off, and come back at the fairgrounds in December to start training for that fairground series for trainer Brad Cox. But Forte, a nice win. You got the three grade one winners and the two grade one runner-ups, National Treasure and Verifying, also running in that juvenile. Don't forget, we've got videos up on the channel on the classic speed figures, the juvenile speed figures, and the top distaff speed figures. Make sure to watch those videos. And do me a favor, smash that like button. That's how we're going to get more views. And don't forget to hit subscribe as we get you ready for the Breeders' Cup 2022.